The Moonshiner role for me, out of a total of 10, sits at... Last month, Rockstar released their newest character role to Red Dead Online, and it's ticked many boxes for me in terms of what I was looking for that all-important fourth role. The follow-up to the big September update had to be top notch, and for a lot of people it really was, but at the same time there's been some big issues with it. In this video I'm going to be reviewing the Moonshiner role in full, breaking down the role into three sections and giving each element a rating out of 10. At the end of this I'll give an average score from each section to give a final marking out of 10. I'll be touching on the bug issues that have been rampant with this role, but I won't allow these to be an influencing factor here, as Rockstar could potentially patch these soon, which would make the final mark outdated. Of course, a year from now, if we're having exactly the same issue, then we have to take into account the bugs, but for now I think it's fair to leave these out of it. I will touch on these later though. So let's start with the first section, which is arguably the most important of the lot, gameplay. The Moonshiner role is a nice fusion of both mission-based content and more focused character role gameplay. Operating the day-to-day running of the Moonshiner business involves various activities, mainly, as you'd expect, the creation of Moonshine itself. However, this is something that rather than taking part in, you task Marcel downstairs to create. All your job is in this section of the role is to select the strength and flavor of the Moonshine. A section of the role that goes hand in hand with the actual creation of Moonshine is ensuring you've got the correct herbs and other ingredients to create the most profitable moonshine. I think this element is great as it gives another way of using your collected herbs and ingredients. Let's say you're running low on ingredients for the most profitable moonshine, you can head out and search for the herbs you need, ready for the next batch that you make. Beyond collecting herbs for personal use in tonics and cooking recipes, I think Rockstar have been really clever here in adding a role-specific way of using this part of the game. So after you've set the moonshine off, chucked your ingredients in, and waited out the period of time it takes to make a batch of moonshine, you're then required to deliver this to the buyer. This for me is probably the worst part of this role. It's essentially a reverse fetch quest, which personally I feel is the worst part of the gameplay of Red Dead Online and also Red Dead Redemption 2, the story mode. With that being said, you do come into some hassle along the way with these deliveries, with revenue agents along the way sometimes trying to take you out at checkpoints and beyond those checkpoints. So this does add another layer to the task. But still, driving a wagon is so monotonous, and the bottles in the back of the wagon break way too easily for my liking. I mean, whoever packed that wagon needs to stick some paper or straw or something in the back there, because frankly, it's a fucking joke. You can go over the slightest of bumps in the road and bang, there goes a bottle of moonshine that costs you money at the end of the mission. And it's never an appropriate fraction of the final amount. A delivery of $220-ish with a smash bottle will get you around $170-$180. That's like $40 or $50 for that first bottle smashed. That is way too much in my opinion. Anyway, ranting aside, I think there's other elements of the gameplay within this role that help pad the Moonshiner role out. Alongside the standard role-related events like deliveries and sabotaging the competition, the story missions offer a nice release from what can be quite a dull set of activities. As I'm sure you all know, the story mode follows Maggie Fike, the character we were introduced to in the trailer for the Moonshine role, and these missions feature some great bits of gameplay. For the next 30-ish seconds, I'm going to discuss a couple of missions, so skip to this time on screen now if you'd like to avoid spoilers. To be honest, if you've not played these missions, it's nothing massive in here anyway, just thought I'd let you know. The standout section of gameplay for me was when you defend a boat along the coast from revenue agents trying to take you out. The reason I love this sequence so much was because it really broke up the combat from the standard horseback, wagon, train, or boots on the ground style. Weirdly enough, actually, me, Hazard, and Pineapple discussed this idea of having some gunfights on board a boat on our podcast a few months ago. Another sequence I loved was during the Certainty of Death and Taxes mission, where you're running through the fire chasing Hickson. I can't remember a similar section during the story mode of Red Dead, let alone the online section of the game. I suppose setting fire to the crop fields in the story was similar, but this for me was way more intense and was very enjoyable. So the missions are good, and despite the fact I said some of the day-to-day activities in the Moonshiner role are quite monotonous, the feeling of the grind, it wasn't as prominent in this role for me as roles like the Bounty Hunter, which personally I found to be a proper grind. Overall, the gameplay with both the standard events of the Moonshine business and the accompanying missions puts this section at a solid 7 for me. It was enjoyable while I was doing it and while the missions were fresh and new, but unlike a role like the Trader, where hunting for animals is one of the main elements of keeping the business running, I can't really see myself rushing back to create batches of moonshine, beyond the attraction of the cash that it offers. I'm sure I'll keep replaying the missions, but to me, I think the mark of a 7 is fair. It was great at first, and now is just okay. During this video too, if you've got different marks for each section I discuss here, then please let me know below. It'd be really interesting to see your opinions on the Moonshiner roll and maybe get some average markings out of 10 like mine at the end of this video. So on to the next section, unlockables. With every character roll released so far in Red Dead Online, you're able to make your way through 20 levels of progression. With each level comes an unlock, be this a special skill, an item of clothing, or even a horse. With 44 unlocks during the Moonshiner roll progression, there is quite a lot to unpack here. The unlockables, as in every roll, are split into two sections. The upper section here is automatically unlocked as you make your way through the levels. This section contains roll tokens, skills, and business unlocks to increase your productivity within this roll. There's also a few minor little emotes here as well. The rest of the unlocks below are available to you as soon as you reach the lowest rank within the section shown. For example, as soon as you hit level 5 as a Moonshiner, you can unlock everything in the promising kit using tokens. But each item in the upper section has a specific level to unlock. So if I was to review the items here, unfortunately for me, this is where the Moonshiner roll is really let down. In other roles, you're able to unlock things that benefit you in areas outside of just that role. For example, equine assistance unlocked as an established collector allows your horse to collect herbs for you without having to get off its back. This is a skill you can use beyond the progression of just a collector role, helping you out even with the Moonshiner roll and your day-to-day collection of herbs. Another good example of a skill that's transferable to the rest of the game is Eagle Eye Plus, which is unlocked at rank 7 of the Bounty Hunter. This one allows you to sprint and gallop while you're using Eagle Eye. This is massively useful in the collector role, as you can quickly find items without being kicked down into a slow walking speed when using Eagle Eye. Unfortunately, the Moonshiner role doesn't really have any significant unlocks that improve your experience in Red Dead as a whole. It has to be said though, you can unlock an increased capacity for materials and ingredients sections of your satchel, but for me, this really isn't a big deal like Eagle Eye Plus or Equine Assistance. Equine, is that such a weird word, isn't it? Let me know if I'm not pronouncing that right, I'm sure someone will. Beyond upgrades to the business itself, the standout feature of this role for me is the Moonshine Shack and the bar and band expansions you can get with it. Despite the fact it isn't technically yours and it belongs to Maggie, it is nice to have a building like properties in GTA where you can come and go as you please and to an extent customize. The biggest draw for me was unlocking the bar and then subsequently the band. I think it's a really good addition to the game and I think it's something great for role players especially, or just for people who appreciate seeing that your character can not only skillfully blow people's heads off, but also play a nice little tune on the ivories. And let's face it, back then, they'd be ivory as fuck. All in all, with a couple of average cosmetic unlocks, no big skill upgrades, but with a Moonshine Shack and a pretty decent horse in the higher tier, the Norfolk Roadster, I'm going to give the unlockables for the Moonshiner roll a 6 out of 10. A final note on this section is that despite the fact you technically unlock items by playing this role, you still have to purchase pretty much everything you unlock, which for me is pretty disappointing. Like the season pass Red Dead Online, it would have been nice to have a few more items that were free of charge. With the emotes and the other bits at the top section of the unlockables, there are some available now, but I think a few more would be appreciated by the player base. So moving on to our final section, originality. Originality is something that's quite difficult to add to the second variation of a game in general, like Red Dead Redemption 2. It's especially difficult when the game is set in a time with limited technology and also the willingness of Rockstar to try and keep the game as historically accurate as possible. This limits their additions like alien guns and spaceships that are seen in GTA 5. Despite the historical inaccuracies of the Moonshiner roll that have been highlighted by multiple players and people online, it does have some redeeming qualities in the originality category. The first being the fact that, as discussed earlier in the video, there are missions that run alongside the day-to-day operation of the Moonshiner business. This is a unique feature for a character role in Red Dead Online. Of course, as mentioned, there are some notable gameplay sequences in these story missions as well, so that's a point in favour of the Moonshiner roll for originality. In addition to this, an introduction of a cutaway property is unique for Red Dead Online, but of course is something we've seen before in GTA 5. I appreciate that not all of you care about GTA 5, but I feel it acts as a good benchmark for something to compare Red Dead Online to. It's a free roam world developed and run by Rockstar, and one that's now in its 7th year of consistent updates and player numbers. Despite all of the above, there are still some features of this role that we've seen already in others, particularly the trader role. Rockstar did highlight the relationship between the Moonshiner and trader, even requiring you to be a level 5 trader to unlock the Moonshiner. Of course, they also included your co-founder of the business, Cripps, in the story of the Moonshiner role. However, this doesn't distract from the fact that the core of the role is to set the maker off on a task, provide the materials to complete that task, wait a bit, then come back to see it ready to be delivered. then of course deliver it. Unfortunately for me, despite the extra padding of the story missions and the property, the originality for this role is a flat 5 out of 10. I think my love for the band in the bar is something that's really pulling this score up, if I'm honest. So finally, with a mark of 7 for gameplay, 6 for unlockables and 5 for originality, the Moonshiner role for me, out of a total of 10, sits at an average of a 6. Overall, looking at it, I think this is a fair mark, but as I said earlier in the video, I'd love to hear what you think. Maybe you agree or disagree with me on some sections, please let me know. A final note I'd like to add to this review is that the role is still plagued with bugs, as I mentioned earlier in the video. I was hoping that the weekly patches would have dealt with these issues, but unfortunately not. Be it the Moonshiner shack not being accessible, the NPCs not even being present when you're inside the shack, or deliveries not registering as completed and you losing a whole delivery of moonshine. These are issues that really need addressing. I'd like to think Rockstar are working on them in the background, and I hope we see a resolution to them soon, as they're slightly tarnishing the new update with these problems. After the September update, I don't think anyone expected them to drop another character role until at least late January 2020, so it'd be a real shame to let the extra attention Red Dead Online has got recently to be sullied by these bugs. But unfortunately, seeing as it's a month on and they're still present, I think that might have already happened. Regardless, I enjoyed playing the Moonshiner role, and I'm very excited to see what Rockstar have in store for us loyal Red Dead Online players in 2020. I'll be here along with you, playing and enjoying the game, and I hope you all have a quality year. It's probably a little bit late now to wish you a happy 2020, but there it is, happy 2020. If you'd like to see reviews for the other three roles, then please let me know. I've loved making this one, so would be interested to see if you lot are up for seeing more. For now though, you can check out my last video in which I explain a tip for the Moonshiner and Trader that makes life a whole lot easier when it comes to leveling these roles up and making easier cash. Thanks for watching. I'm JmCooKie. Cheers.